Namaste to all. In this video, we will see some more details about idol worship. I have been making so many videos that Vedas, Almighty God prohibits idol worship, but there are still further questions from a lot of you, both in Facebook as well as YouTube. Idol worship may not be efficacious, but it is not a sin. That's a question to Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. Answer by Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. Injunctions are only in two forms. Do this and do not do this. Example, Vedas say, thou shall speak the truth or thou shall not tell a lie. The commission of these do's is virtue and their omission is vice. Similarly, the omission of the don'ts is virtue and their commission is vice. When you worship idols, which is forbidden action, why are you not a sinner? That means people who are doing idol worship is obviously a sinner, and it is, as it is not accepted by Almighty God in the Vedas. Another question is, look here, Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati, the Vedas are beginningless. They were revealed in the beginning of the creation. At that time, there was no need for idols. The method of worshipping through idols was introduced by Puranas and the Tantras. When human knowledge and capacity deteriorated, they could not comprehend God. It is easy to fix one's mind on the idols. Therefore, idol worship is meant for the ignorant. Just as each step of the ladder has to be passed in order to reach the top of the house, and it is not possible to climb direct from the lowest to the highest rung of the ladder, leaving other rungs in the middle. Similarly, idol worship is the first step. When by practicing idol worship, there will be an awakening of the mind and internal organs would be divested of the impurities, it will be possible to make direct conception of Almighty God. So that's a question. He is saying the idol worship is the first ladder, and to reach the Almighty God, the formless Almighty God worship may be the last ladder. So we have to climb the first ladder is the question. Answer by Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. When virtue is that which is in consonance with the Vedas and vice that which is in dissonance with them, then according to your statements too, idol worship is proved to be a vice. Vice means anti-Vedic. To follow anti-Vedic books amounts to being an atheist. Manu Bhagavan says, Nastiko Ved Nindakaha. Manu says that he is an atheist who disrespects the Vedas, forsakes them or acts against their injunctions. That means people who are doing idol worship are also atheist as per Manu Bhagavan. The books made by anti-Vedic and undesirable persons drown the world into misery. They are useless, spurious, chaotic and tend to make miserable both this world and the next. Next world means next birth of the human being. The books made in opposition to the Vedas are only periodic and soon fall out of fashion. It is useless and misleading to rely upon their authenticity. All the sages beginning with Brahma right up to the sage Jamini have been of opinion that nothing should be accepted which is against the Vedas. The real righteousness consists in acting according to Vedic injunctions. Why? Because the Vedas inculcate the right principle. All the Tantras and Puranas which are contrary to the Vedas are spurious. Idol worship which is enjoined by these anti-Vedic scriptures are also sinful. The worship of lifeless inert objects does not increase the knowledge of the human. It rather decreases. It is the association with the men of learning alone that increases the knowledge, not the worship of blocks of stone. Can anybody ever be successful in making a true conception of Almighty God by worshipping idols? It is impossible. Idol worship is not a ladder. It is a big ditch by falling into which man is smashed into pieces. He can never come out of it and is sure to remain there till he dies. For the realization of Almighty God, also there are ladders, but they are not idol worship, but the association with men of learning, that means with Rishi Munis. Beginning with ordinary level, gradually going up and up, just as a man does when he has to go to the upper story of the house. As well as practicing the rules of conduct such as truthfulness, etc. Nobody has ever become learned by worshipping idols. All idolaters remain ignorant till death overcomes them and terminates their unsuccessful career. Those who are worshipping idols at present or those who will do so in future are bound to fail in the achievement of the four boons of life, Artha, Dharma, Kama, Moksha, that is righteousness, prosperity, happiness and emancipation, and will perish in the end. The right target for aiming at the realization of God is not the worship of idols, but the association with the men of learning and close observation of nature. Progressing gradually, step by step, one attains God also. One more common question normally most of you get in mind is this one. You can fix your mind at an object which has some form. It is very difficult to concentrate upon a formless almighty God. Idol worship is therefore very necessary, is the question. Answer by Maharishi Dhananda Saraswati. The mind can never remain fixed on a gross object. It grasps the object in an instant and then begins to wander from part to part. But the mind can run to its full capacity in the formless God and even then fail to come to a limit. As God has no part, it would not be restless, but would go on thinking about God's attributes, activities and nature till it is in a kind of ecstasy and stands still. Had it been possible to concentrate the mind on a gross object, all persons of this world would have had their minds concentrated, as people are all through engrossed in worldly objects such as wife, son, wealth, friends, etc. and their mind remains restless. It is only by setting the mind at an object which has no parts that it can be concentrated. Therefore, idol worship is bad. Truly wonderful answer by Maharishi Dhananda Saraswati. I hope you would have understood. If not, please see the video once again. My Acharya also always says that when you concentrate on an idol, your mind one time it will go to the eyes of the idol, then one time it will go to the ears, one time it will go to the mouth, one time it will go to the full face, etc. So it will keep on wander, it will become restless and you will not be able to concentrate. And that's why my Acharya always say that we should not concentrate on any idol or any picture or any photo, etc. The way in which we have to do meditation or dhyana of Almighty God has to be learned personally from an Acharya who has attained Samadhi, who has realized Almighty God and the Vedas in his Samadhi. Idol worship is anti-Vedic. Idol worship is not the first step to attain Almighty God. In fact, some people say that idol worship is like kindergarten and formless Almighty God. Vedic worship is like PhD, etc. You have to go from kindergarten, first standard, second standard. These are the things which many of the modern saints also speak, which is again absolutely wrong thing. If you do not study correctly in the kindergarten, you will not be able to understand anything when you go up. So similarly, if you say that idol worship is a kindergarten spirituality, that is absolutely false. We cannot do idol worship because idol worship is not accepted by Almighty God, and because God does not have any idol. Natasya Pratima Asti, Ajurveda 32nd chapter 3rd mantra says, that means of that Almighty God there is no statue. So God does not have a statue, then what statue we can make of Almighty God? The statue which we have in our house of great dignitaries, Sri Ram, Sri Krishna, these people were not Almighty God. These people were not avatars, because avatar is not possible. I have made many videos. I will give you the description in the link. Please go through it. And when it comes to the photos of Sri Ram, Sri Krishna, etc., these photos are not to be worshipped. Sri Ram, Sri Krishna worship the Almighty God as mentioned in Vedas. We have to worship the same Almighty God whom Sri Ram, Sri Krishna worshipped. So I hope you would have got a fair understanding on idol worship and why it is prohibited. You can drop out messages. If you are still not satisfied, I will try to come back with more information. Please request you to spread my videos. Someone who is really eager to understand Vedas may get the video if you like and if you share the videos. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om.